So just in case you don't know, video is made up of still images. So you probably heard the term frame rate, 24 frames a second, 30 frames a second, or 60 frames a second, even up to like 120 frames a second and higher. That just basically means that that's how many still images are in the frame every single second. So what I'm going to do today is show you how to extract one of those high-res still images so that you can use it, especially if you're a coach or a course creator and you need those thumbnails either for your YouTube thumbnail, for some of your content, your course thumbnails. I'm going to show you as a beginner how to extract those images using Final Cut Pro. Hey everybody, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Mike Gomes and I teach aspiring entrepreneurs how to take what they know and turn it into a profitable, thriving online business. But the one thing that I've always been known for with my clients and that I want to bring over and have it translate well into this channel is how I love to simplify things, because I think in today's world, we overcomplicate everything. So in following along with that, today's video is going to be a really simple, short, and concise video on how to export a high-res still image out of your video production for your YouTube thumbnail, for your course thumbnail, and I'm going to show you how to do it in Final Cut Pro. So let's jump over to the computer and I'll show you real quick how to do that. So here we are in Final Cut Pro, and actually you're looking at the actual video that you're watching right now, and you'll see at this last little section here, this is where I actually did my thumbnail poses, which again, link in the cards, link at the end of this video. You'll be able to see why I do that and why I do these poses. It's just easier because the camera's running, so you do a few poses for your thumbnail, and I'm going to show you basically how to extract one of these images really quick to use for like you're in Canva or whatever graphic editor you use so that you can design either a YouTube cover, a course cover. First of all, let's find us an image. I did a bunch of poses, and to be honest with you, I felt like a complete idiot doing this because I really didn't have an idea for this thumbnail for this video in mind. So hopefully by the time you're seeing this video, the image, the thumbnail is a great thumbnail, and maybe it even helped you to click on this video. So let's see what kind of poses I ended up doing. Again, the easiest way to do this is just, that's kind of a funny face. This is my first time looking at this, by the way, so you guys are seeing this firsthand. That one's actually not bad. So I didn't have an idea for this thumbnail, and so I just tried a couple different poses. And then at one point, I know that I raised my desk and I stood up. Let's see. So I was trying to think, okay. Here I am pointing my fingers because I didn't know exactly where my graphics were going to be, right? Like I have no idea exactly what my graphic, this is me, hopefully maybe even holding the Final Cut Pro logo, maybe, you know, I don't know. Don't know what I'm going to do. That's why I do so many different variations when I do my video. So here's me scooting back a little bit. So I had a little bit more room. This is my first time looking at this. This looks a little weird. There's a nice normal cover right there. That's a good one. Let's look at a couple others and then we'll just pick one. See, I just did a bunch of different ones. Here's me raising the desk in my office. Let me see. Yeah, here's a couple good ones. Here's where I stepped out of the shot. And this is just, again, a tip from the other video that you can watch. Is this is where I stepped out of the shot so I can get a clean background plate that I can use in Canva. Okay, here's a couple. I had no idea. What am I doing? Okay. Here I am holding my little petite Final Cut Pro logo. Oh, it's so cute. Okay, well, anyway, let me show you the process is the same no matter which one you choose. So let's go ahead and run with this one. And I'm going to put a link in the cards to another video that I did up above here that I did a few weeks ago on what to do with that image after you export it out of Final Cut and putting it into Canva and how to create a really engaging YouTube thumbnail from scratch. And in that video, I even share with you some tips on how to get those thumbnail images before you stop rolling the camera. So take a look at that. It'll be in the cards up above and also linked at the end of this video. Okay, once you get the playhead where you want it, you're going to come up here under File. You're going to come down here to Share. Now, you're not going to see the option right away because I removed it because I wanted to show you how to add it in case you're just starting out with Final Cut and you won't see this option in here. So you can see how we have like a DVD, export files. We have a few kind of presets already in here. If you go to Add Destination, this way you can quick set it up for next time. You'll see this option right here, save current frame. You can just drag and drop this. And I drag it to the top because I use it a lot. And then right here, you can create your settings. I don't do TIFF files usually. Usually I'll do either JPEG or PNG. I like PNG because they're really high quality. They're easy to use pretty much in any program that I use. They're easy to upload to my website. JPEGs are definitely a little more compressed and smaller. Whichever one you want to use, go ahead and select it. That way it's already always preset. You can obviously change it on export anyway. These are just kind of the presets you want to go with. So go back here under File, down to share, and now you'll see that we have the option for share or save current frame. So you're gonna click that. This is gonna pull up again your settings. You have the chance, you can either just hit next and it'll go and it'll export out according to your current settings. Or you can click on settings and come in here and change again the setting. Maybe we decide we wanna do a JPEG this time. I'm gonna actually put it back to PNG. And you hit next, and it's gonna ask you where on your computer you wanna save it. So we're just gonna do it right to the desktop and click save. And there you have it, it's that simple. Once it's saved to your computer, you can then upload it into whatever graphic program you use and start designing your thumbnail or your course thumbnail, or you can use it on your website. So there you have it. I hope that video was really concise and helpful for you. If you found this video helpful, please give me a thumbs up, give me a like. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you want more of these video tutorials coming up. They're gonna be short, concise, and to the point. And as promised in the end cards, I'm gonna include a link to the video that I did a few weeks ago on what to do with that image. After you're done with it, put it into Canva, create a really nice YouTube thumbnail so that you get higher click-through rate. Thanks for watching, and I will see you on the channel next time.